name is Greg Hager.
Suchi Saria.
Archana Venkatraman.
Ilya Spitzer.
My name is John Krakauer.
Jeremy Brown.
Russell Taylor.
I'm Jeff Sievertson.
We really are trying to create a new approach to engineering around healthcare delivery.
The Malone Center provides almost the ideal venue for encouraging this integrative sort of research.
It starts right outside those doors in the clinic. Being able to formulate the problem really requires us to work closely with clinicians and see what they're doing, hear from on what the challenges are, work with surgeons like the ones at Hopkins, because they not only want to lead the field, they want to change it. So that's the kind of environment where we want our engineers to start working on problems.
You know, the Malone professorships are being given to people who want to do a little bit of disruption like that.
The primary benefit of something like the Malone Center is that it brings together people with different perspectives, training, and even biases in order to tackle these challenging problems, which are very relevant for a space like healthcare.
One of the big values to me of the Malone Center is fostering this kind of interaction. And secondly, Malone Center is interested in translational research. In other words, we want to make healthcare better and actually help patients rather than just publish papers.
The things that I'm most excited to working on right now are developing better methods to evaluate and assess a surgical trainee's skill using these surgical robotic devices like the Da Vinci.
Now, our projects are basically trying to use gaming and interactive emotional experiences to further patient recovery after brain injury. So, for example, we have created a game based on a physics engine that simulates the movements of cetaceans like dolphins and killer whales in order to learn faster and reacquire skills after injury.
What we've done is brought together some of the latest techniques that allow us to take these kinds of messy health systems data, and in sepsis, which is one of the leading causes of death, shown how we can improve outcomes.
Up till now, there has been no successful hand rehabilitation device. And I think the fact that we can bring together designers, people working with data analytics, patients and clinicians, all in a single team to say, we want to build that device, we want to make it work, and then we want it to scale out into the world. That's really the sort of success that we're going toward.
Of particular interest is these so-called missing not at random problems, where the reason data is missing has to do with the data itself. What you're going to see is complete data is only on days when things are going well, and incomplete data is on days when things are going poorly. We need to figure out how to adjust for these things appropriately. In other words, given this data with question marks, in what way should we massage it, as it were, to make it approximate what the sort of true underlying data is.
In the case of focal epilepsy, these seizures are originating in certain regions of the brain. And so an alternative management strategy is to actually cut out, go in and remove that area of the brain. Our idea is to take non-invasive imaging and see if we can shorten that invasive step of the procedure. So that's, again, using different flavors of multimodal integration, different flavors of analysis to tackle a problem that there's been a lot of work to date in various fields, but no one has been able to do it from a system level perspective.
People want to come to the Malone Center because they say, I can be part of an amazing team that's really going to revolutionize healthcare. And I'm really proud that we've got the people in place to do it now, and they're generating the ideas that I think are actually going to make that possible.